Antibiotic resistance, that segues right into this. Here's a pneumococcus on a gram stain. So you know in this sample, there's a lot of pneumococcus around, right? You know, 10 to the 8th, 10 to the 9th, 10 to the 10th organisms per milliliter. That's a lot of bugs. And there they are, all causing trouble, all that inflammatory stuff going around. So in the mid to late 90s, we quickly found out that the beta-lactam drugs were finished for treating pneumococcus. So they're penicillin-resistant and non-susceptible strains had arisen. Then later on in the late 90s, third-generation cephalosporin resistance started to increase too, so that if the amount needed was in the range shown there in micrograms per milliliter in the CSF, that they may fail. And this had to do with, you know, the pneumococcus. So that's where the recommendation for vancomycin came, because there aren't any pneumococci really resistant to vancomycin. So vancomycin plus the third generation cephalosporin over the month of age with definite or probable meningitis due to bacteria should be the empiric drug of choice. And that's what the Red Book says currently. And if you got resistant isolates that are highly resistant, then you need to consult your local infectious disease specialist who takes care of children to help you, or else you're not going to be able to handle it.